Hello, good morning, welcome to my channel. My name is Monique and my channel is called Dutch Monique because I'm from the Netherlands. And today I have a wear test from a foundation. And it's the foundation from Zoeva. I've ordered it online. I hope the color is right. A few months ago, I think it was October, November, it launches. I haven't seen much reviews of how it is, so I thought, well, I have it, I haven't used it yet, so this is the first time that I'm using it, so I thought, well, let's film it and see what if I like it or I don't like it. I hope the color is all right, because I usually go to the store and let's see for my color which is right for me. This is the color. I have chose the color 050N. The N is for neutral, beautiful. What I like about Zoeva is that they have give their foundation beautiful names. Yeah, this is beautiful. Like power or not like you always see fair or sand, beige, cocoa, hazelnut. No, they have all beautiful names. So, well, I have cleaned my face. I have serum. I put some day cream on. So I will now put on from Illamasqua, I set my base for the foundation. So I love this very much. It's a jelly substance. There's a little spoon with it, so you have to scoop some out. First you have to swirl, then I scoop some product out of it and I will prep my face. So I'm now using the camera as a mirror. I have a little mirror here beside me. I love this very much because it's very hydrating and I have a dry skin. At least this part, that's oily, and the rest of my skin is dry and it always feels tight. If I don't use day cream or something like that, it's always tight feeling and I don't like that. So do my chin, let's see how it is. Yeah, that looks all right. As you can see, I have some red spots. I will get you home. Sorry. You come a little bit closer to me so you can see all my imperfections. As you can see, I have some redness here on my nose, also on my cheeks and my chin. And here in the corners, it's blue. It's always blue here. Yes, I do get enough sleep. That's not a problem. It's something that I have. And I think it makes me look old. So, what I use for that, I will show you. But let me first close that bottle. From Revolution, I have a corrector palette. So I use the green for the red spots, and I use this color for my inner corner eye. So that is what I'm going to do. I start with the green on my nose. So, and I just tap it. And I always think I could, when I have done this, I could join circus because I look like a clown. But when the foundation is on it, you don't see it anymore. So on my chin. And some on my cheek here. So the green I was working with, so a little bit more of the green here. So, so that's what I do. Then my eyes. I'm using the pinkish one. The pink one. The other is more, a little bit more orange, salmon color. In Netherlands we say salmkleur. So I use that on. So here in the corner, just tapping it. So it doesn't show, well, it shows less when I'm having my makeup on. So, that one. So how's your day? I have a free day from work today. I have to work this weekend. What are your plans? Do you have plans? Are you going to do something nice? Are you going out or have a party? Something like that. Well, that's how I look now. So, as you can see, I can join the circus. Well, the moment of truth. Did I choose the right color? I will shake it. I always shake my foundations. I'm not sure, but it is in a glass bottle with a pump. And I use my sponge. I have one pump on my sponge and I'll begin on this side first. Oh, maybe it is too light. I don't know. Well, too light isn't that bad because you can correct it with bronzer, but too dark is a problem, I also think. But it gives a good coverage, it blends well, it blends very well. It hasn't got a strong scent. I don't like it when it's smelling strong. Well, it. No, I think the color is right. You see? I hope it shows on camera. Can you see the difference? So there's one drop. Well, I think the color isn't bad. It is at least a color for in the winter, not in the summer. In the summer, I am a little bit darker, not much, because I don't sit in the sun, but I always ride on my bike, so my face gets a lot of sunshine. Well, don't forget your ears, hey, ladies. I don't think it's bad. Oh, gives the coverage I like. Medium, light to medium coverage. Yes. I think I like it. Well, let's do the other side of my face. One pump. So. I like using a sponge. I prefer a blending sponge more than a brush. Let's see. It doesn't settle in the fine lines. That's also very nice. I think I'm happy with it. Yeah. Nice. It feels nice. It feels light. Alright. My first impression is positive. And I think I can get away with this color. It's exactly, yeah, I think it's a good color, yes. What do you think? Is it a good color? Yeah, yes. All right, well, I'm going to put my makeup on. I will be right back, so stay here. Don't go anywhere. So, I'm back. This is the look. This is how it turned out. Let's start at the beginning. What I used. I used this primer from Elemaska. Very nice primer. It's one of my favorites. I've been using the Zoeva foundation. I wanted to tell you how much it was, but I forgot to look the price. The price I leave down here under in the comment. No, not in the comment, in the but you know in where. I can't. Don't know the words. In the same more box. Okay. I use that. I have to grab it. I set the foundation with the Nabla setting powder. Then I've used the bronzer from Sleek. This color, I've received this palette in the Look Fantastic box. So, if I am correcting it right. Then I've used on my eyes, oh, it's very shiny, from the Douglas. It's the Pink Nudes. And this is how she looks like. And I've used the colors. Let's see. This is base, and this is transition color. And I use this color, this glow one, in the outer corner, and I have used this color, this Victorious, on the eyelid. So it's a very nice palette, very good quality. I love it. It's available at the Douglas. Mascara, Mia's. At first I didn't like it that much because it has a very strange brush or wand. How do you write it? I always hear you say wand for this. I want to see how you write it because I'm curious about it. I've been searching but I can't find it. So I've used that concealer. I've used a new concealer. I bought it yesterday. It's from Catrice. And it's with a little sponge on top, and you have to turn it up. And then you can very precise do it for your underneath your eyes. And this is a hydrating long wear concealer with medium buildable coverage. So anti-wrinkle. That's also a very good thing about it. But before I did put on my eyeshadow, I used this little primer that is from Creative Cosmetics, and I've received it in a box, a Dutch box, a Dutch beauty box that's called Style Tone. And I received this little pot. It's very expensive, 18 euros, but it is fantastic. It is my favorite. It really is my favorite. All right, my eyebrows I did with the from BB London, the Ultra Slim Brow Definer. I just made it. Look, this is all that is left of it. So this was the last time that I could use it, so that is going away. Blush from NYX. In Sweet Cheeks, and this is a very nice color, and this color is called Fig. And then on my lips, I've used the lip liner from the Makeup Factory, and there isn't a color. Oh yeah, no, 09, color 09. On my lips, I have from Bobbi Brown the Crushed Liquid Lip in the color Hippie Shake, one of my favorite colors and products, lip products. And highlighter I have used from Laura Geller, the highlighter, this one. And this one I have received in my very first Look Fantastic box. And it's still one of my favorites. So, well, that's it. That's the makeup that I'm wearing today. And I will see you tonight. Let's see what's left of it. Alright, see you later. Bye! Hi, just a quick update. It is now 12:30. I'll show it to you. This morning I applied my foundation. I forgot to say it was 10 o'clock this morning, and when I look in the mirror, I see that it's fading. I will come a little bit closer. Let's see, my chin is fading. That's normal. I wore a scarf, so that was against it. I always tuck in my scarf, so that's normal. Little bit by the nose, it's fading, but I've sneezed, and I used a handkerchief, so that's pretty normal. Further, it looks all right. It still wears all right. So, well, just a few hours to go. See you tonight. Bye. Hi, I'm back. Well, it's 7 o'clock now. I will show it to you in the evening. Almost 7 o'clock. See, oh, like that. I applied the foundation on at 10 o'clock this morning, so that's a 9-hour wear test today. So what are the results? Well, I will show it to you. I will come a little bit closer to you. Here by the nose, it is gone. Here the chin is fading. It's the same as this afternoon. On the cheeks, there's still enough foundation. I still can see my highlighter and my blush. So, I'm pleased how it is after 9 hours. By the nose, yes, that's to expect. I sneeze my nose, I use handkerchiefs, so sometimes my nose is itching and I'm doing like that. So yes, that is to expect. My chin is always something that I'm expecting because I like to sit like that. Yeah. So, and further, it is still beautiful. Yes. I'm very pleased with this foundation from Zoeva. My overall thoughts. It applies well. It wears nice because like I said, this is my oily part and the rest is dry, and it wasn't heavy on me. It still feels like I'm having nothing on my face, so it's like a second skin, like your own skin. That's also how it feels. Yes, I'm very pleased. It applied well, it blended well, it dried very quick. So, yeah. Yes, that are very good points for the Zoeva foundation. I wanted to say concealer. No, foundation. I saw that they have a new concealer, so that's now in my head. Where I was thinking of. So, all right. The price, I have looked it up. On the Zoeva site, it costs 26 euros. Do you buy it here in the Netherlands at the Douglas? It is cost 27 euros and 75 cents. So 1 euro and 75 cents more expensive. The shades, they have a lot of shades. I've counted 44 shades. So that is very, very good. Did it transfer? Probably, because on my chin there's not much left, but I didn't notice it. It didn't show up on my fingers, it didn't show up on paper, I didn't see it on my scarf. So I was out this afternoon and I wore a scarf and I didn't notice it on it. So transfer, maybe. It faded where it has faded. It's on the normal places where all my foundations are fading. It's always my chin, it's always around my nose. But yeah, that is because I'm like this and like that. And yes, I see, I always sticking my fingers on my face, so that's my problem. So yes, I'm very very pleased with this foundation. And yeah, if you have a dry skin, it wears nice, it doesn't feel taggy, so great. So I certainly recommend it. The shade, although for me this is a winter color for me, I think that if I want to wear it in the summer, I need a little bit darker foundation. So this was very almost too light. I could make it work, I did make it work, but it, oh yes, I prefer just one step darker so that I can use it also in the summer. So for me this is a winter foundation. Well, never mind, I have enough foundations that I can wear in the summer, so that is absolute no problem for me. Only this one, not this color, that is not for me for in the summer. In winter, yes. So yeah, that is my opinion of the Zoeva foundation. Do you have the Zoeva foundation? Let me know, what do you think of it? Do you like it? Don't you like it? Let me know, I want to hear it. And if you like this video, give me a thumb up and leave the comment down below. And I will speak to you soon. Have a nice evening. Bye.